everybody, welcome back to my channel, and this week is Lunar New Year, so I am giving some book recommendations for the Year of the Dog. So you might be wondering what I am wearing, and this is called a hanbok. It is actually a modern take on the traditional hanbok, and we wear this in Korean culture on New Year's Day in order to celebrate the holiday, and we also eat a dish called dakguk. It's for good luck. It also adds a year for us onto our lives, and then we spend the day with our family and we pay respects to our elders. So we do a certain traditional bow. For girls, it starts like this and you bow down to the floor. For men, your hands can be up at your sides. But we do that as our tradition for every New Year holiday. Now, this year in Korean culture is the year of the golden dog. Now, I've actually heard that in Chinese culture, it's the year of the earth dog. I don't know what the difference is and why there's a difference, but yes, we call it the year of the golden dog. And I thought that it would be fun for me to give you some book recommendations for the year of the dog based on attributed personality traits of people born the year of the dog. So if you were born in 2006, 1994, 1982, 1970, and onwards, then you are meant to have a lucky year this year because you were also born in the year of the dog. So for the personality trait of loyalty, a dog will be loyal no matter what. They will never break from that loyalty of the people that they love. And I chose Truth Witch by Susan Dennard for this because Safia and Isolde's loyalty to each other, their friendship, their fierce love for each other, and what lengths they will go to for that love and that friendship. However, dogs also do tend to have a personality trait of being stubborn. For this one, I chose The Bells by Danielle Clayton. The reason that I chose this is because the main character, Camilla, is very stubborn. She has beliefs about what she needs to do in order to be successful and be the favorite, and she will never veer from her stubbornness in wanting to achieve those goals, even when things start to not go exactly how she wanted them to go. She still has this drive and the stubbornness in her in order to move forward. And even though I do think that sometimes stubbornness is seen as a negative trait, I think that in Camilla, it definitely does her some service because she does accomplish a lot of the things that she wants. Now, whether these things lead to good things like she expected is a different story. Dogs are also very good-natured. They seek family and they seek roots, and they will defend home no matter what. Now for this, I chose Redwall by Brian Jacks, and this is one of my favorite books from when I was a child. This is all about mice who live in an abbey called Redwall, and all of a sudden it is put under threat by Clooney the Scourge, who is a rat who is coming to invade and take over the abbey. So in order to defend their abbey, the mice are willing to do almost anything, but they also do it with a lot of grace because they are peace-loving animals. And I really love this story because it had a lot of hope. They were underdogs. They were trying to defend their home and each other, and I just found it very heartwarming. And I've always loved this story ever since I was a little girl. The next personality trait of a dog is someone who is selfless. They will do what they can to help others. However, when they are betrayed, there's a lot of pain and shock involved in that. And for this one, I chose Days of Blood and Starlight by Lainey Taylor. Now, the reason why I chose this book, which is a second book in the series, is because I think a lot of Karu's selflessness does come out in this because she has discovered some certain things about her past. She's decided that she wants to fight for herself and for her people, and she does it through a lot of selfless means. She does get injured and hurt a lot in her journey in order to help her people, and so it is kind of hard to read because you love Karu and you love how strong she was in the first book, and her strength in the second book is more internal and it's more quiet, but I think it's just as strong because she does go through a lot of self-sacrifice for her people. However, there are moments where she does eventually get betrayed, and in those moments there's a lot of pain involved. The nice thing is that Karu is such a strong character that she doesn't let that get her down for too long. So the final personality trait is that unfortunately there are times when a dog trust in the world is thrown into doubt, and when this happens they go into a very pessimistic mode where they think that there's no good in the world and they're just very pessimistic about everything. And for this one I actually chose Want by Cindy Pond, and that's because the main character Jason has a lot of pessimism in his faith in the world. It's because he's seen a lot of people get very sick and die because of something that is man-made, and that is pollution that is happening in Taipei. So the pollution is so bad that people can't breathe well, and it's affecting people's health, and they are dying faster. That is everyone except for the very rich who can afford these suits that help them breathe good air. And I think that anyone can imagine that if you are someone who can't afford those suits and who's just trying to live your life, then there's a lot of pessimism that kind of grows within you. That happens to Jason as he tries to fight for the people he loves and to find some equality in and justice in his society. So those are all of my recommendations for the Year of the Dog. I hope everyone has a happy and healthy New Year. If you like this video, I'd really love a thumbs up or a subscription to this channel, and I'll see everybody next time. Happy New Year! Sehe bok mani patiseo! Thank you.